Blank space. Writing that song was a journey. It was one of those things where I would be writing lines years before I ended up constructing the song.
Oh my God, look at that face. You look like my next mistake. Love's a game, wanna play.
I'll be going about my daily life and I'll think of like, wow, so we only have two real options in relationships, like it's going to be forever or it's going to go down in flames. I'll jot that down in my notes. One will be about a breakup song, one will be about betrayal, one will be about falling in love. I'll come up with a line that I think is clever, like, darling, I'm a nightmare dressed like a daydream. And I just pick them and put them where they fit and construct the bridge out of more lines I'd come up with in the last couple of years. So it was really more like a crossword puzzle. Blank space was like the culmination of all my best ones, one after the other. Every few years, the media finds something that they unanimously feel is annoying about me. Me, my character, the way I live my life, the way I talk, the way I react when I win stuff. It's like, there's always like a unanimous verdict of like, that's annoying about her. 2012, 2013, they thought I was dating too much. Because I dated two people in a year and a half, but whatever, we'll leave it there. Oh, a serial dater. She only writes songs to get emotional revenge on guys. She's a man-hater. Don't let her near your boyfriend. It was just kind of excessive, and you know, at first it was hurtful, and then I kind of found a little bit of comedy in it.
What you want, be that girl for a month. Wait, the worst is yet to come. Oh no.
This character is so interesting though. If you go and read these gossip sites and they describe how I am, so opposite my actual life. You know, I can get these guys, but I'm just like a nightmare and I'm clingy and I'm awful and I throw fits and tantrums and there's drama, but then they leave, they can't stay away, so they come back, but then I drive them away again. Emotionally fragile and just like unpredictable mess that like, just oh my God, I painted a whole picture for this character. She lived in like a mansion with like marble floors, and she wears Dolce & Gabbana around the house, and she like wears animal print, unironically. And so I created this whole character, and I had fun doing it. Once the song was written, my favorite line of the song was, got a long list of ex-lovers, they'll tell you I'm insane, but I've got a blank space, baby, and I'll write your name. I watched as it got so misconstrued, it turned into, got a lonely Starbucks lovers, they'll tell you I'm insane. Whatever it was, I was saying something about Starbucks, which was kind of like the most delightful misunderstanding about this song, which was written about misunderstandings. Half the people got the joke, half the people really think that I was like really owning the fact that I'm a psychopath. Which is fine, either one's fine, as long as they know the a semblance of the words, even if they are incorrect. It was number one for like 8 or 9 weeks, so I have no complaints as to how things turned out.